I was asked to talk about how to systematically go after astigmatism. What should be in your head? How do you come in and look at a patient and conceptualize, I'm treating this patient for astigmatism, check off the boxes. You look at every step that you're doing in the process of doing the cataract surgery, maybe treating dry eye, correcting astigmatism, and you look at all of the steps and you make sure that you're not having a waste of either the process or you're not having redundancy. You have to segment your surgical process and identify waste and variables. And what you do is you tighten that up and you improve your outcomes. So conceptually, I put the refractive cataract surgery into three areas of pre-op, intra, and post-op. And these are sort of the sections that I focus on. For me, automation is key, because I have those preoperative measurements wirelessly transferring to the laser. So there's no chance of transcription error. I don't have to worry. Intraoperatively, the laser is automated. So if you're looking to put a nomogram into your laser, just pick one. Pick one and then modify it yourself. Lenzar gives you the opportunity to modify that nomogram, and your clinical apps person can show you how to do it. You look at your results. If you're getting under correction is a certain level of astigmatism in a certain age range, you can go in and modify and customize that nomogram in your laser right now with the software that they have. And then you track your post-op data, you know, and adjust and come back and fix patients and enhance them. One thing that we did was we looked at our data for astigmatic incisions. That's part of the process. And this is a study that I've shown before where we took patients all over a half a diopter, and we actually went up to about 1.9 diopters because some patients didn't want to spend the money on a torque lens, so I pushed the envelope a little bit for them. And really, they had great results. We saw that the mean preoperative corneal astigmatism was just under a diopter, the mean residual refractive was under a quarter, and it was stable out to a year. By going back and doing multiple iterations of your nomogram, looking at your data, you have to look at the data and close the loop in order to be confident